About the fact that Tully Blanchard was injured in Greensboro, North Carolina, in a match with Dusty Rhodes, Johnny.
And I'm glad we got the tape. We're going to be able to see what happened right here. You know, Dusty's been on a rampage. The tape is right here. The match is already in progress. And here's J.J. Dillon bringing a chair into the ring. Now, you know they did some damage to Dusty before with that chair on the leg. Kansas City before he lost the belt to Flair. And one other time. And now here is J.J. getting hit.
It's Dusty now with a chair. He got J.J. with it, knocked him out of the ring. He cut Tully down with it. Look at him work on that leg now.
He bent the chair almost in two, whacking it on the knee of Tully Blanchard. And now
he's going to go to the figure four
right here. He's got Blanchard in a lot of trouble right here. J.J. has been disposed of. He's outside that he don't know where he's at. There's Dusty grabbing that rope in the figure four. It's the same move that Ric Flair grabbed the rope to use the leverage to win the belt from Dusty in St. Louis. Now, there he gets rid of the referee.
Here comes another referee. He's going to go through the ropes and out of the ring. Dusty's just refusing to break it. J.J. again tossed through the ropes and outside as he still got the figure four and still got the pressure on the leg.
And Tully Blanchard in terrific pain right here. The extra leverage by grabbing that second rope by Dusty Rhodes. And he just went wild. He's got rid of both officials. He got rid of James J. Dillon. Here comes the Midnight Express in there. Bobby Eaton takes a tumble. Dusty really cleaning house all the time. He's got that hole on the leg of Tully Blanchard.
Dusty Rhodes continuing to put the pressure, continuing to have that figure four leg lock on Tully Blanchard, and he's refusing to give it up. He's not going to quit, regardless of what anybody does.
He's had a lot of trouble in the past with the four horsemen, and he has swore for vengeance. He put Ole out once, and he said Tully was next, and he's really got that figure four, and that's the hole to do it with. It's done right in the ring. Tully Blanchard in tremendous pain. Dusty has cleaned house of everybody, has come to Tully's aid, and Tully is still stuck in there, suffering in that figure four.
Tremendous pain and nothing that Tully can do to get out of it.
And of course,
there suffering through it.
Somewhere in these few minutes that he's got that hold on, comes the damage to Tully Blanchard's leg. And Dusty continues to grab that rope for more leverage on that figure four, which works on the knees of the opponent.
Well, Tully Blanchard, the Four Horsemen, Ric Flair, Ole and Arn Anderson, you know, they have been working over Dusty Rhodes.
They've been trying. Dusty Rhodes had said, Bob, it was time to take care of business. He was going to do some hurting instead of just winning the matches. Now look at him. He's going to go up to the top just like they done on his and right down on that knee of Tully Blanchard. J.J. Dillon very concerned. And out of the ring goes the referee again. Dusty's going wild. Here's the other official in the ring. He's going out again. Out goes Bobby Eaton.
Look at J.J. down on that leg. J.J.'s just trying to protect that leg. Here's Dusty again now.
After under
the top rope.
Right on that knee. And of course, as we alluded to on the program, Tully Blanchard has had an injury. He had to be to that leg.
All right, and fans, we'll be back. We'll have more after we take this time out.
When you ride a Snapper Hi-Vac, you get a little something extra. The power of a huge vacuum.
Don't know what Dusty Rhodes did to Tully Blanchard. Tully in a brace on crutches at this time, but that's only the beginning of the story because we talked about the retaliation from Tully and the Four Horsemen.
You know, what the bottom line gets down to Charlotte, North Carolina, James J. Dillon manipulated and got a contract where if Dusty Rhodes or Magnum T.A. lost the fall in a cage match with Ole Anderson and myself, they could not be at Starrcade. So the next best thing is eliminate Tully Blanchard so Ole Anderson doesn't have a partner. Well, I'm pretty well eliminated from the Charlotte scene tomorrow night. But you know, Dusty Rhodes, but that just flagrant, pure flagrant infraction. What you do? 5 minutes in the figure four, hitting me with a chair, jumping off the top rope on me, and then the film quits. It doesn't show you coming in the dressing room, attacking me in the dressing room, does it? Knocking doctors over. As Dick Murdoch likes to say, what happens in the ring, you just stick with it. You just put a little spit on your wounds and go for it. Well, Dick Murdoch in the dressing room is not in the ring. So that puts it in the realm of the world. So Dusty Rhodes, what happened to you at the hands of the Four Horsemen? Ha! You had coming, big boy! And you think about it, when you got that cast, that was just a warning, Dusty Rhodes. It could have been very well been your head.
What happened is he should have been fined. He should have been suspended. The NWA didn't do it. So we had to take matters into our own hands. and we set an example and show you how we deal with people. Take a real good hard look.
It's total manipulation.